Are you ready, Mia? Yeah, I know, I'm excited too. Oh, hey, fellow scientists! Mia and I just arrived at Snowcap Mountain for our big ski trip. But, where's the snow? And is it just me, or is it really warm out here? I don't get it. I thought Snowcap Mountain would be, you know, snowy. I was thinking about the climate, not the weather. Well, what's the difference? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to tell the difference between weather and climate and describe the three climate zones. Let's investigate. Well, since it looks like our ski trip might not work out, let's try a new plan. Imagine you want to go on a beach vacation somewhere warm and sunny. Where would you go? Sunny Florida, maybe? Or someplace like Hawaii, where it's warm all year? Ooh, or maybe a tropical island in the Bahamas. How did you know those places would be warm and sunny, though? You didn't pull out your phone and check their weather forecasts, right? You knew because that's what it's usually like in those places. That kind of long-term pattern, how warm or rainy or snowy a place usually is, that's called its climate. And it's not quite the same thing as weather. We learned that weather is what's happening in the atmosphere at a certain place and time. If someone asked you what the weather is, you'd probably look out your window or check your weather app and tell them what's happening right now, whether it's warm or windy or stormy. And we know that the weather is always changing. It can be sunny in the morning and pouring rain by lunch. A windy day can turn calm and a chilly morning might warm up fast. That's just how weather works. It's always moving and changing. So how is weather different from climate? Climate is the usual weather in a place over a long time, like 10, 20, or 100 years. Climate doesn't tell us what's happening in the atmosphere right now. It tells us what kind of weather we can expect in a certain place most of the time. Unlike weather, which changes a lot, climate stays pretty much the same. Arizona has a hot, dry climate, for instance. Most days there are sunny with very little rain. It might have a chilly day or even a thunderstorm once in a while, but overall it stays hot and dry most of the time. Alaska has a cold climate with freezing winters and lots of snow, but even Alaska can have a warm, sunny day in the summer. Even so, the climate is still cold most of the year. So even though the weather might surprise us sometimes, a place's climate stays the same for a long time. You can think of weather and climate kind of like your clothes. The weather is the outfit you're wearing. You probably change your outfit pretty often. But the climate is like your whole closet of clothes to pick from, which are likely all a similar style, even if we all have that one wacky outfit we only wear once. Ooh, looking good, Mia. Okay, scientists, think you can tell the difference between weather and climate? I'm gonna read a description of a place, and you decide. Is it describing the weather or the climate? Ready? Here's the first one. It was sunny this morning, but now it's pouring rain. What do you think? Weather or climate? That's weather. It's describing what's happening right now. How about this one? It usually snows in New York in the winter. Something that usually happens at a certain time of year? That sounds like a pattern to me. Climate for sure. Okay, last one. It's 82 degrees and windy today in Miami. The word today is a big clue. Yep, this is the weather. Nice work, scientists. Try some on your own. Pause the video and decide whether the sentences in your guided notes are describing climate or weather. Great work. Now we know that weather is what's happening in the atmosphere right now, like today's temperature, wind, or rain. And climate is the pattern of weather a place usually has over a long time. Since different places on Earth have different patterns of weather, scientists actually group them into three different climate zones. Climate zones are areas of the world that have similar climates. That means they have the same kinds of temperature, precipitation, and weather patterns over time. And climate zones don't just have similar weather, they're usually found in similar places on the globe. When we were dreaming up warm, sunny places, we thought of Florida, Hawaii, and the Bahamas. What do you notice about where they're located on the globe? They're all near the middle of the map. The fact that all of these places have similar climates is no surprise, it's science. Imagine drawing a line around the center of the Earth. This imaginary line is called the equator. This area gets a lot of sunlight all year long, which is why places around the equator in both directions are part of the tropical climate zone. Tropical climates are hot and humid with lots of rainfall. You'll find rainforests, jungles, and warm beaches here. And it's pretty much summer all year round. What do you think the climate is like when you get far away from the equator? Way up at the top and bottom of the globe are the North Pole and South Pole. Places near the poles, like Greenland or Antarctica, are part of the polar climate zone. Polar climates are freezing cold for most of the year. They get very little sunlight, and even summer days can be chilly. Polar places have long, dark winters and short, cool summers. Even though we might picture snow and ice when we think of places in the polar climate zone, they're actually very dry. Some polar regions get so little precipitation, they're actually deserts. That means it doesn't snow very often. But when it does, the snow tends to stick around for a long time. So, if tropical climates are hot and rainy, and polar climates are cold and dry, what do you think the climates in between are like? These are the temperate zones. They are found between the tropics and the poles. Places like the United States, most of Europe, and parts of Australia are all in this zone. And the weather here? It's a mix. Temperate climates have four distinct seasons of weather. It gets hot in the summer and cold in the winter. But instead of extreme heat and freezing cold, like in tropical and polar climates, the weather in temperate climates is usually more mild. In fact, the word temperate even means mild, like my favorite spice level of buffalo wings. So, tropical climates are hot and rainy, polar climates are cold and dry, and temperate climates are somewhere in the middle. Which climate zone do you live in? Let's review everything we've learned today. Climate is the usual weather in a place over a long time. It's different from weather because weather changes from day to day, while climate mostly stays the same over many years. The globe is broken up into three major climate zones: the tropical zone near the equator, where it's hot and rainy, the polar zone near the North and South Poles, where it's cold and dry, and the temperate zone in the middle, where there are four distinct seasons and the weather is more mild. To learn more about climate, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Even though snow-capped mountains' climate is cold and snowy, today's weather had other plans. So no skiing today. How about a sunny mountain hike instead? Great! I hope you packed the sunscreen. Wait, can robots get sunburned? Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time! Hey, hey.